Do you sometimes need to pay for services before you actually get the service? Well, if that's the case, then you should watch this video very carefully, Prepayments to Vendors. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. When making a prepayment to vendor, the recommended method is called check to accounts payable method. This is the correct method of recording prepaid expenses with vendors. With this method, the vendor records are perfectly accurate at each stage in the process. The unpaid bills report reflects any open transaction that has not been applied, and the unpaid bills report is the most important report, and it is always accurate if you use this method. The chart of accounts will be temporarily out of sync with accounting theory until the service that you paid for is received. Once that happens, then your chart of accounts will be perfect. And if you have to report your numbers before you receive the service that you paid for, there's a quick fix that we'll talk about later in the video. So how do you do the check to account payable method? When prepaying for an expense to a vendor, we use the checks or expenses window. We will put the accounts payable account in the category field as the account that we will pay. Vendor's balance is negative to reflect that they actually owe us until the service is received from them, the vendors. And when the service is received, simply enter the bill for the service on the day it was given, the way we normally would when we enter a bill. And then the very last step is to apply the accounts payable check back from step one to the bill that you entered into step four, and everything will equal out perfectly. For example, let's imagine on April 20, we paid a new vendor, Risa Repair Ranch, to fix our equipment. We paid her with check number 8795 for $500. She agreed to fix our equipment before May 31 and will notify us when she is finished. Now, what do we do here? We make a check to account payable. So, we click New, and then we go over to Vendor, and then two rows down, we click either Check or Expense. It doesn't really matter. When you open it up, you have to put in a new vendor. So you click Add New. This is called adding a vendor on the fly, and it will work with customers, accounts, and service items at the moment you make a transaction. Risa's Repair Ranch. And you could always reopen the vendor permanent information to put in the rest of her information later. Now, this is on April 20, and of course, it's not repair expense because we have not yet incurred that expense. She has not yet repaired the equipment. So this check in the category field is going to go to accounts payable. Accounts payable. So we know that it's Risa specifically and it's account payable. And the amount of the check will be $500. And of course, we're imagining we'll print it later. And we could just as easily use the expense window for this very same transaction. We're paying this vendor from this bank account this amount of money. But we're not stating what the expense is because we have not yet incurred it. The only thing we know is she will owe us the money until she delivers the service. Now, When we click Save and Close, we can click Reports, and then of course go to Custom Reports, Unpaid Bills, and now we have this new vendor up here. Look at this, Risa's Repair Shop. The total is here, one transaction, and notice her balance is negative. Her balance is negative because she owes us $500 worth of future service until she actually repairs the equipment. Now let's imagine on April 21, Risa returned our repaired equipment good as new. She gave us a copy of the paid bill. So what do? We enter the bill normally, even though it's paid, and apply the April 19th check to net the vendor's balance. So what should we do? So April 20, we click New, and we come over here to Bill, and we put the bill date April 21, and again, still 2017, it's Risa's Repair Ranch. Now, this time the category is repair expense, because we do have the repair expense on the day that she actually gave the service and delivered the repaired equipment. And the amount is $500, because that's the value of the service that she gave us on April 21 when she fixed the equipment. So that's easy enough to record. Now we click Save and Close, and when we look at Risa's Repair Ranch, we see a positive $500 for the bill and a negative $500 for the check. This is when we incurred the expense, and this is when we paid it. What we should really see on the unpaid bills report is zero for Risa's Repair Ranch, and these two should be netted against each other. We learned in a prior video the only way to do that would be to make a $0 bill payment as of April 21. So we click New, and we go to Bill Payment, and we choose the filter because we want to see all dates, and we want to only see Risa's Repair Ranch. Now what we're seeing here is the check, because the check is a positive number in the vendor balance the way a bill is. So we're going to click it, but notice QuickBooks knows that there's $500 of credit available because this check is being applied to this bill. The $500 credit comes from the check. So when we click, be careful that the payment date is the same date that she physically delivered the service, April 21. Don't forget it's 2017 in our little story. So be very careful that we're paying zero and using the $500 check that we gave to apply to the bill that she gave us, which was already paid. Click Save and Close, and now the unpaid bill report does not have Risa's Ranch at all, because the two numbers are netted against each other and the two transactions are no longer open. Now, as I mentioned earlier, if you need to report your financial statements after paying for the service but before receiving the service or item, you will need to make a typical normal accounting adjustment, usually a journal entry, to move the negative balance of any vendor's accounts payable records into an account called prepaid expenses. Don't worry, your accountant will know how to do this if you need to stop at any point and report your numbers.